Hello everybody and welcome back to Stellaris. Now it's certainly a very turbulent time in the Fevarian Republic. We are currently looking at the newly discovered Borbegon system, which is the last known location of an ancient alien relic that we found out was called the Rubricator. In addition to this, our scientists are also looking into an ancient alien weapon of supposedly war-ending proportions. So our people are probably feeling a little bit uneasy as to all of this dangerous alien technology being explored. In addition to this, MSI proved to us last time that they have no intention of leaving us alone and that they are going to continue pursuing us violently to hold us to their contract. And finally, we have an unknown empire that we're starting to establish contact with to our galactic north. And without knowing any more about these creatures, our people are probably pretty scared and feeling pretty unsafe right now. So we're going to try and navigate our empire through all of this uncertainty today. And we're going to try and come out on the other side stronger. So we have a couple things from last time. First things first, we finished this archaeological site down here in the Rubid system. We were looking into the a colony of this ancient alien empire called the Gruner, who were apparently at the war with another empire called the Ball. So let's go ahead and look at this. Data crystal records show that the Gruner waged war against the Ball, desiring the plentiful resources purportedly found on their planets. A set of system coordinates has been successfully extracted from one such record. Our archaeologists are uploading the planet's location to our systems now. Perhaps a closer investigation of Urugasti 3 will prove fruitful. Alright, so that's going to issue a special project form about colony investigation.
Situation log updated.
And we're going to find out where exactly this is. So we're going to go find in our event log, former Ball colony investigation available. So let's go ahead and let's go to it. Okay, so it's in Urugasti 3, which is right here. So we're going to go ahead and take our scientists and we're going to move them over here to research this special project. We have a scientist down here who is going to survey the system neighboring the Rubricator system. And I think we'll move our construction ship down here to establish control over all of these systems for our empire. We have a colony ship that's on its way to colonize this Gaia world. And we have a construction ship on its way to build an outpost in that world. So it looks like for our next election, our Commissary General is going to win a re-election yet again. We're okay with that. They've proven a good leader for us. On our home world, we have specialist unemployment, but we actually have three available jobs. So we just need to wait for the specialist to demote into a working class citizen. All right. And we've found another encounter in Jolwar. So I guess this will be our second alien species. Let's see if we can find their ship in the system and find out if it's going to be some manner of like space fauna or if it's going to be an actual sentient empire. Now I don't see any ships in here, so that remains to be seen.
Construction complete.
So let's go ahead and let's build a starbase. We'll queue up a couple more star bases. Right now, our limiting factor is alloys. On our colony, we have 3 housing and 5 available jobs, so we're good there as well. All right, the Psi Menace has stationed a vessel at our border, broadcasting a repeating signal. It was a challenge to translate the message, but our linguists believe they are inviting one of our representatives to a multi-day cultural exchange event on their ship. Absolutely not. We're not gonna fall into any traps. We don't know if we can trust these guys yet.
Construction complete.
All right, and we've got a special event. Looks like a Paragon has come to visit us. A Turion. Our scans reveal that the outer shell of the robot is hundreds of years old. Its voice is monotone, but its words are oddly resonant. Data indicates misalignment between your government and its subjects. Lack of discipline. Substandard indoctrination. Recommended action? Addition of a Turion to the system. Eliminate unnecessary functions. Prioritize order. I don't know if I like this guy's outlook for managing an empire. You know? Discipline, obedience, indoctrination. That's not what we're about. Why are you here? Every society is an equation. Allow a Turion to solve yours. There is no need for uncertainty. Why do you wish to join us? Your civilization approaches ideal conditions. Perfect balance can be attained in the shortest period of time. A Turion has calculated the likelihood of success at 91.1%. Yeah, that might be success according to you, but I don't know if that's going to be success according to us. Who created you? Irrelevant. Tell us more about these equations. From a port on the robot's chest, dozens of holograms are projected. It launches into a droning explanation that includes statistical analysis, economics, psychological profiling, genetic manipulation, and so on. One of the holograms is a progress bar. It indicates that the presentation will last another 127.8 standard days. Oh my gosh, what do we get ourselves into? I don't like the sound of this guy. He's calling us inefficient. He seems like he's all for order, discipline, indoctrination. He's far too robotic for us, so we're gonna dismiss him. We don't want to have anything to do with this guy. Our construction ship is done, and I think we are going to go ahead and build mining stations in this system. Give us some more energy and minerals, which we desperately need. And I think it's time that we test out our new flagship. So I'm going to go ahead and move this flagship into the Toyobo system, where we last time we found mining drones that came out of this asteroid. So we're going to go ahead and send that flagship over there. And to support the flagship, we are going to have our fleet follow. When we get there, we'll watch the battle unfold. All right. Our lack of interest in their invitation has offended the Menace. Well, we didn't know if we could trust them. Their tone has dramatically changed. Our linguist translated some hostile language within their follow-up communication. It seems they do not want to take a no for an answer. The answer is still no. We're not going to risk any kind of trap from them. We've already been trapped by one alien species. It's not going to happen again. Our recovered asset isn't going where I told it to go, so I'm going to go ahead and give it the move order again.
Anomaly
go
found.
To this asteroid. Secret Heart. Resonance imaging of the U5619 asteroid suggests an internal composition consisting of rare crystals. Where is this? This is in the Ednit system. Alright, let's research it. I'm going to go ahead and bump up our speed to fast for now. We can always turn it back down to normal if we find we're getting overloaded with events. Menace. The second rejection by the Menace to invite us to their ship was met with a strong emotional response. We received communication from multiple alien crew members for several hours, and what our linguists believe was an attempt to guilt us for not attending. Last I checked, these were the aliens that were actively trying to dissuade us from translating their language. They didn't seem to want to establish first contact. These communications, along with intercepted signals from their ship, have allowed us to decipher enough of their language to have a working understanding. We can now initiate more appropriate diplomatic connections, although they have taken this initial incident negatively. Alright, so we're establishing first contact with the Mythfell Order, and obviously their initial opinion of us is going to be quite negative. It's changed by negative 250 because of our actions. We will deal with that.
Has established communications.
All right. Heed this message, aliens. I represent the Mythfell Order, led by the illustrious Archpriestess Wings of White One. We rule our region in space under a divine mandate, and so long as you do not mock our faith in what passes for your culture, there may be peace with us. All right, I agree. Peace. Let's just leave each other alone, okay? Do not interfere with our endeavors, and we will not interfere with yours. Second alien encounter. We already know that we are not alone in the universe, yet we found our second contact with another spacefaring civilization unsettling. Just like us, excuse me, my cat is crawling up on my desk. Just like us, the aliens appear to be the relative newcomers on the galactic stage, and their level of technology is similar to our own. There are truly no good Xenos in the cosmos. It was foolish of us to think otherwise. Acknowledged. All right. Well,
special project complete.
Looks like they have control over to our east and north. So I don't think we're going to be able to expand out further any more this way. And we have closed borders for all new first contacts. And I think we're going to leave it that way. They don't seem to want any relationship with us, and we don't want any relationship with them. All right, so we found the formidable colony. Despite the promise of riches suggested in the ancient Gruner data crystals recovered from rubies, Urugasi 3 is a dry, barren world, void of atmosphere. Let's check out, where is Urugasi 3? Yeah, this is the supposed former bull colony. Does not look very habitable and rich. Fortunately, geological scans have revealed near endless trove of fossilized remains deep in the planet's sedimentary record. Among them is a plantoid species, most likely to have been the bull, as it is the only one identified in possession of the neurological structures required for sapience. A targeted excavation should uncover more information. All right, this is going to create an archaeological site in this system that we can uncover. So I'm actually going to pull this construction ship over to this system once it's done with its current job of constructing a mining station, so we can begin the archaeological excavation. Our head of research needs a level up, and we're going to go ahead and give our head of research statistician, because this gives them a counselor effect of research speed plus 5%, which is the most important stat for a head of research to have. One of our science ships needs orders. That's of course this science ship, which we're going to use to excavate this site once we get that outpost built in the system. For the time being, I see a anomaly here, and I think we're going to go ahead and research this anomaly in the meantime. I don't know why we missed that one, but we did. Let's go ahead and let's continue moving our construction ship here. We're going to establish control over the Borbagon system. And I think we'll push out to Drolwar once we've gotten this surveyed. Fleet order canceled. The ISS Yusoram was unable to build a starbase. That's probably because we are lacking in alloys. That's okay. We have alloys now. And in terms of getting more alloys, I don't think we can afford to purchase any with minerals or energy and food. We're short on almost all of our resources. Energy emissions. Strong energy emissions of an unknown origin make this asteroid stand out from the rest of its peers in the crowded asteroid field. And this is in the Direp system, which is here. All right. Well, let's figure out why this
council agenda
why this ready. Asteroid is sending out weird energy emissions. Now that we finished exploring Drolwar, I think we're gonna go back and we're gonna explore these systems that we missed back here. All right, and it looks like our military vessels are on their way quickly the Toyobo's system. Food from farmers plus 20%, that's gonna be great for us. Fleet command limit would be pretty good, though I'd honestly rather have the naval cap right now. Increasing our leader caps could be pretty great. Or we could get hydroponics farms. Let's increase our leader cap. Weapons target range. Asteroid B134339 is pockmarked with craters from weapons blasts and appears to have been used as a target range by someone roughly 2 millennia ago. Residual energy readings suggest that they tested increasingly exotic weaponry, including subspace bombs and some kind of singularity generator. Whoa, a singularity generator. I wonder if we can do that sometime. Our scientists would be interested in studying the unusual energy echoes that remain. Wow, interesting. We will definitely study that if we get the chance. While unremarkable on the surface, the U5619 asteroid has a hollow core lined with industrially valuable crystals, like a gigantic geode hung in the stars. With special instructions prepared by Science Officer Bonnie Baerin, any future mining platform should be able to carefully harvest these crystals from the interior of the asteroid. Fantastic, a rare crystals deposit was added. That's up here. That's going to be great for us.
Research complete.
Research complete. Engineering research from researchers plus 20%. Great. And next, I'm tempted by all these other options, but given our energy crisis, I think we need to go for mining station output plus 10%. We really need the energy. How is our fleet doing? Complete. We're making our way? We are. Construction complete? Where? Great. We got the Borbegon system. Maybe we can go claim the Jorlwar system.
Anomaly found.
If you're wondering why I'm claiming these systems quickly without building the mining stations first, it's because I see another alien empire exploring this system right now. And until we know what their interests are, we're going to kind of aggressively expand over this way so we can assert our influence over the area and not let them do the similar thing. And we don't want them to get control of the Jorlwar system, basically. Because we don't know if they're going to be friendly or aggressive to us, and this seems like a good defensive choke point for us to have. A curious signal. Although Darup 5A appears to be totally desolate and devoid of life, our scanners have picked up an encrypted signal emanating from it. Interesting. A signal coming from a desolate planet. Let's figure out what it is. I also want to check out this Perseus system. This is
system
really cool.
Complete.
With this like protoplanetary disk in the system. It looks like our fleet has arrived in the system, and I want to watch this battle unfold, so I'm going to go ahead and take our speed down to slow.
Hostile fleet engaged.
And let's watch this battle unfold. It looks like there's 10 mining drones. I'm going to zoom out a little bit. Okay, so we can see all of these like smoke clouds. Those are left by our missiles. We can see all these lasers. Those are coming from the mining drones, which use lasers as their primary weapon. Love's Labor Lost. Having decrypted the signal, Kali Deden was astonished to discover it was broadcasting an archaic form of one of the main Valdar languages. Speaking in these, thous, and whencefourths, it appears to be reciting one of the lost works of Bani Jacana, a renowned Valdar playwright who lived some 600 years ago. How on earth did that get on a desolate planet so far from our home? We might have been observed by some aliens. It appears that the broadcasting device, a simple satellite dish protected by a small shelter, is the only non-natural structure on the moon. There is no hint as to who left it there or why, but going by the wear and tear on the evidence, it must have been there since shortly after the play was written. Long before the Valdari learned the secret of space travel. We can only assume it was left there by ancient visitors to Fevaria who took a liking to the play and decided to pay our species a strange and unexpected tribute. I wouldn't say further superiority of the Valdar race, but I don't think we want to suppress it, right? Freedom of press, freedom of media, we want to be transparent with our population. So we're going to go ahead and choose this option. And we're going to let our people enjoy the fact that they were paid tribute to by these alien visitors. First contact. I know, I'm sorry we keep getting interrupted while watching this battle. We have managed to pick up a clear audio feed from conversations between several Sin Menace ships. While our linguists are still none the wiser as to the meanings of any words that they are recording, they are optimistic that this new signal will help them make significant progress towards a breakthrough. Great. Now, quit interrupting our battle.
System survey complete.
Okay, looks like we've destroyed two of their mining drones. Three of their mining drones. We'll go ahead and attend all of these once our battle is concluded. I don't think our fleet is optimally constructed to deal with mining drones, given that we're using no shields and their primary weapon is lasers, but I'm not going to refit our entire fleet every time we go into a battle. Because that's tedious and a little bit micromanagey. So I think we're just going to leave our fleet as it is and kind of create a more general purpose all-rounded fleet. The signal originates from the remains of the antenna-like structure. Exploratory probes were dispatched from the ISS Timin to the surface to investigate the matter more closely. What Science Officer Bor Bethan found was a cavernous vault that, while easily pried open, was evidently the last safe house and refuge of some long-dead race of aliens. While reasonably technologically advanced, it seems they never reached for the stars and perished to some planet-wide natural disaster. The vault is immense, housing thousands upon thousands of black boxes that the ISS Timin has not determined to be data storage devices. A special project has been prepared to decode the contents. Alright, we're going to go ahead and look into that special project and decode the contents in just a second. But first, we can choose a new technology, and I think we're going to go for basic combat rules. That's going to be great for us. And it looks like we're just about done with this battle. There's only have three left. And we haven't lost a single ship. We came in with 16, and we're leaving with 16. All right. Great. We can launch a council agenda, which is going to expand the council. And let's see what our options are. Lord High Admiral, for ship starting experience plus 50 and naval capacity plus 1%. Or Tribune of Rights, which gives us pop amenities usage minus 1.5%. I think we're going to go for Tribune of Rights. That pop amenities usage is pretty good. And, yeah. So this takes a governor. Oh, right. And we're waiting for the leader pool to refresh in 2 years so that we can put a hopefully egalitarian-minded governor into the council to make our egalitarian faction happy. We have a science ship with no orders. I think we can take the science ship and we can probably serve it down here. Our colony ship needs orders. Okay, we can go ahead and colonize this Gaia world. Let's give it a good name. Fortalia. That sounds pretty. Yeah, let's go with Fortalia. And we have an open council position. Yeah, we're going to leave it open until we can hire the right person for the job. The 13S-426 periodically spews alarmingly... electric mix of particles and radiation into the void. It's going to take us 600 days, but I think that's going to be worth figuring out. Why is this asteroid releasing all of this radiation? Let's take our fleet and let's move it back to Fevnor, and let's bump this back up to fast speed. We have a construction ship doing nothing. There's a tomb world here. So that might be worth us exploring next. I'm not going to so aggressively push out to over here just yet because this is the choke point that we really want to hold if this alien empire is over here. We'll check it out. And if we can get that system, that's going to be great. But we're not desperate for it. Let's build mining stations here. And let's build mining stations here so that we can hopefully get access to all of this energy. A science ship needs orders. Here's the special project. Yeah, so let's go ahead and let's look into these vaults and let's see what we can learn from them. The Sin Menace. Reconnaissance flights produced from the Sarasus system have reported significant Sin Menace presence, which indicates that at least one major military installation is in orbit around the primary. Although we have not identified any planetary settlements of note, a preliminary target list is being put together in the event that the aliens prove hostile. Several interesting transmissions have been intercepted, which may prove us with enough insights to translate their language. Alright, so this is the Sarasus system. Is supposedly where they have military presence. Okay, that's here. Very interesting. So they must be up and around here, worrying. Hopefully they're not gonna be aggressive towards us. Only one available job, and we need more consumer goods. And we need more energy. Though this still has plenty of available jobs, technician jobs that can be filled. So I think we're gonna leave Desadia to be doing its thing. And I think we're gonna go ahead and build yet another industrial district here. Get up on our consumer goods.
Special project complete.
Our homeworld we're just gonna be kind of treating as a jack of all trades. We're just gonna build whatever districts we happen to need in the moment. And we'll specialize our other worlds, and maybe later on we can specialize our homeworld as well. But for now, we kind of need it to just be whatever is short in the moment. Limbo. The vault is a tomb for hopeful immortals. Science officer Bor Bathan asserts that the huge blocks of ternary code found in databanks are neural images, digitized brain scans. Whoa. Doubtless the aliens of Tamaranda C3 consider this their only shot at any kind of survival following whatever calamity befell their planet. They did not have the means to resurrect themselves, but banked on the impossibly small hope that eventually someone else would have those means. It's certainly not going to be us. We don't need any more strange aliens in the galaxy. We don't know what their intentions are, so we're going to let dead aliens lie. We're not resurrecting anything. We don't know what it is. So this scientist is done with the special project, so we're gonna move to the Aragosti system, so that we can, excavate the archaeological site on the Bull system.
Found.
A feel for steel. The mineral composition of Darab 2 does not match projections. Well, let's see what the mineral projection, the mineral composition is then. Odd that this system has been like partially explored but not fully explored. I wonder what we did to pull a scientist off
construction
from that,
complete.
That system. Teachings of warriors. Across the barren fields of Darab 2, there are indications of old battles being fought. Beneath the lifeless ground, our researchers on the ISS Yavaldim have found bones, metallic shards, and most surprisingly, a container filled with documents. If we send the documents to our homeworld for translation, we could potentially learn more about this war and who fought in it. It would also be possible to simply sell them off as antiques. No, we want to research this. We want to find out. What can we find about these warriors' texts? Issue special project.
Updated.
Is this going to take a science ship, or is this just going to be 19 months society research? Yeah, let's translate these texts. Let's learn about this ancient war. We can go ahead and build mining stations.
System survey.
We can go ahead and build research stations. System surveyed in the Darab. All right, let's continue surveying out this way, and let's survey Ubalon too. I see it has a tomb world, which isn't great. We can't settle on tomb worlds, but maybe eventually we can. And I think it's also worth moving our construction ship once we're done building these mining stations to get the extra energy and minerals over to Huawei so we can get our next colony up and going. Technology discovered, mining station output plus 10%. Oh, that's a relief. That's going to be really good for us. We could go for another 10%. I'm tempted. Worker resource output is also going to be really good. I can't tell which one's better. This one actually takes us to additional technologies. So I think we're going to go for worker resource output. Again, we're just trying to get more energy and minerals in our empire right now. All right, the scientist can go ahead and excavate the site. This is our head of research, who is our archaeologist. And we can go ahead and upgrade all our ships. I think these have level 1 armor, but in the last episode, we actually researched the technology for level 2 ship armor. So let's go ahead and make these ships more robust. Illicit matter. The ISS D'Arm finds disturbing tangle of technology hidden in a deep crater on the asteroid's surface. Evidently, someone has, by rather simplistic means, managed to stabilize a one-way wormhole. Wow. Science officer Gary Baeren suggests that the asteroid is an exit point. The other end opens up somewhere in uncharted space, some light years away from a black hole, and small quantities of dark matter are leaking, being siphoned through the wormhole. Whoever set this up seems to have abandoned the operation. Wow. Well, we might be able to harvest some dark matter from this wormhole then. From the black hole. The ISS D'Arm has discovered a previously unknown strategic resource on 13S426, dubbed Dark Matter. This exotic substance has many properties that seemingly defy several natural laws. It could potentially revolutionize the sciences. Wow. Yes, anomaly please. Found. Signs of battle. A large amount of ship debris can be found in orbit around the planet, possibly the remnants of some kind of massive fleet actions. Yes, let's look into it. This scientist leveled up, and since they're exploring for us right now, we're going to go ahead and give them the explorer trait, complete. Which gives them extra survey speed and anomaly discovery chance, which is great for an explorer. Our construction ship needs orders, and for some reason we didn't build this mining station here. We can go ahead and build a mining station here, and I think we can probably build our next outpost in the Rublon system to get 3 minerals anomaly and 6 found. Energy, which we need right now. Astonishing asteroids. Observing the massive asteroid MFT-668, we have found something. Further investigation is warranted. That's so vague. What is this something? I guess they know how to catch my attention, huh? The treachery of the Sin Menace. While some were worried of the incursion of unknown alien vessels within our space, it was not clear until now how much of a threat the Sin Menace posed. It seems they just sent a covert space force to intercept one of our cargo vessels in the Jorlwar system. Are you kidding me? However, it is a stroke of fortune we have had several warships concealed nearby that were able to arrive to the scene quickly. The enemy vessel was destroyed as it sought the escape, but its remains may yet yield some useful information. Okay, so they're going to be ships aggressive upgraded. Towards us. This toxic and lifeless world appears to have once been inhabited by a moderately advanced pre-space civilization. The ruins of their cities are strewn across the surface. All right, let's learn what we can from this ancient civilization. I'm noticing a pattern. We're discovering lots of ancient civilizations in the galaxy. There's supposedly like a Zvan laboratory in this system that we need to figure out. There's the Rubricator. There's the Gruner here, and there's the Ball here. Signs of battle. There is clear evidence that a massive space battle took place in close orbit of Rubilon 4 at some point in the past 5,000 years. The surface of one side of the planet is pockmarked with craters from stray weapons blasts, and scanned from the ISS to Dirim have picked up several hulks on the ground. Though these wrecked ships are all in very poor condition, the fact that anything remains after all the damage they must have sustained is a testament to their advanced design. Science officer Bonnie Baeren is preparing an expedition to sift through these derelict hulls for any valuable technologies.
Situation log updated.
That's going to be great. So after we're done surveying the system, we're going to go ahead and we're going to...
System survey complete.
We're going to beam down to the surface of that planet and learn what we can from this wreckage. Monoliths. Impressive structures litter Rubilon 6's surface, practically begging for some archaeological work. Yeah, let's figure out what that is. We can level up our scientists here. We're going to give them explore because, again, this is another person who's just surveying for us. This is going to give them survey speed and anomaly discovery chance, which is great for us. All right, nuclear devastation. Our survey of the Weiser 3B has revealed that it used to be a a pristine continental moon with mild climate as little as 1,000 years ago. In stark contrast, the atmosphere today is extremely toxic. The surface is highly irradiated and the world has long since lost the ability to support life. We have detected signs that the moon was once the scene of an incredibly destructive thermonuclear war waged between factions of a relatively advanced indigenous pre-space civilization. Wow. That could have been us. That could have been us. Since these guys have turned aggressive, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to move my military fleet out to the Droll War system so we can defend our interests here. If they come back with another aggressive push into Droll War, we're going to be ready for them. This science ship needs orders. Yeah, okay, looks like they've established a claim over this system, so we're not going to go explore that way. We're going to continue exploring down this way.
Special project complete.
Our language experts have been at it for weeks to try and translate the documents we found in an old battlefield. Today we finally have some results. We now know that the fallen warriors all follow the teachings of a philosopher called Talisa, the Teller of Tales. These documents are breakdowns of tactics, strategy, and most importantly, logistics of interstellar warfare. Being a strong spokesperson against war, Talisa still found it to be essential knowledge for steering into the future. Even the most peaceful of people might be forced into a corner in their work for a better world. Splendid. Gives access to the Master Teachings Warring States Empire Edict. Let's check out this edict. I'm curious. This is going to give us naval cap plus 10%, an army upkeep minus 15%. That's really good. Now I'm kind of torn if that's going to be better or research subsidies. Maybe that's going to be good while we're at war and we need to build up a better fleet. For the time being, our naval cap is kind of pitiful, so hopefully we can get a technology to increase that. Halito is missing planets. All calculations point to the existence of several more celestial bodies, yet they are nowhere to be found in the system. Sensors have been recalibrated and numbers rechecked, but the theory stands disproven by reality. We have marked the missing planetoid positions on our star charts. Perhaps a closer scan of the system could reveal more. Is that creating like a special project or something? No. I guess we'll just continue surveying. Rubalon 6 is an uninhabited and indeed uninhabitable, but not unvisited, while its surface is littered with tall cenotaphs carved from some minerals not native to the planet, evidently placed here by some artistically inclined spacefaring race. The monolith's flowing lines deftly chart a history so fantastic it must surely be fictional. Surely. Wow. How cool. How are we doing on our planets? Zero housing, so I think we need to build a city district, and we are lacking the minerals to do that. Very short on resources here. Let's build 500 minerals so we can build a city district here. Okay, we have plenty of housing there, and our colony here is almost up and running. And I think this is probably going to be a good stopping point for us. We've accomplished a lot today. So we established contact with the Mistfell Order, and they basically said, stay out of our way. And we can't disagree more. We don't want to get in their way, and we don't want them to get in ours. We do have one border system between us, right here, and I think we're just going to keep out of their way, and we're just going to keep to ourselves. As long as they said they want to maintain peace, I think they're a peaceful empire. Yeah, they're pretty pacifist, so I don't think we need to be too concerned security-wise. And maybe in the future, we might have cause to try and establish some more friendly relations with them, though we were off to a pretty bad start. We are colonizing another planet, so this is going to be our second colony, and our third world under our control. It's a Gaia world, and it looks absolutely pretty. That's going to be up and running in just a few months from now. Down here, we are looking into these aggressive Sin aliens, and we kind of aggressively pushed out our control over the Droll War system because it has a lot of strategic importance for us as a bottleneck system. And these guys are being pretty aggressive towards us, so I think that was the right move. Right, so stay tuned for the next episode, and I'll see you next time.